I, Mrs. K.S. Katgir from Department of Electrical Engineering, AISSMS IOIT, Pune, today will explain shift register counters. Let us understand what a shift register counter is. A shift register counter is basically a shift register with serial output connected back to the serial input to produce special sequences. They are classified as counters because they give a specified sequence of state. Two of the most common types of shift register counters are ring counter and a Johnson's counter. Let us see the working of the ring counter. Figure shows the logic diagram of a ring counter. The output of the each stage is connected to the D input of the next stage, and the output of the last stage is connected back to the input of the first stage. The clear followed by the preset makes the output of the stage 1 as 1 and remaining outputs as 0, that is Q1, Q2 and Q3 are 0. This can be seen from the sequence diagram. If you look at the sequence diagram, you can see Q0 is 1, Q1, Q2, Q3 are 0. When I give the first clock pulse, Q1 becomes 1, Q0 becomes 0, Q2 becomes 0 and Q3 is also 0. When I give the next clock pulse, Q2 becomes 1, Q0 is 0, Q1 becomes 0 and Q3 is 0. When I give the next clock pulse, Q3 becomes equal to 1 and Q2 becomes equal to 0. When I further give the clock pulse, at the fourth clock pulse, again Q0 becomes equal to 1, Q1 is 0, Q2 is 0 and Q3 is also 0. That is, the sequence keeps on repeating. What is the sequence? When clock pulse is 0, Q0 is 1, Q1, Q2, Q3 are all 0, 0. When I give the first clock pulse, Q0 is 0, Q1 is 1, Q2 is 0, Q3 is 0. At the second clock pulse, your Q2 becomes equal to 1. And all other outputs are 0. At the next clock pulse, Q3 becomes equal to 1 and all the other outputs are 0. At the fourth clock pulse, Q0 becomes equal to 1 and all the other outputs are 0. You can observe that 1 is always retained in the counter and simply shifted around the ring, advancing one stage for each clock pulse. In this case, 4 stages of flip-flops are used. So, a sequence of 4 states is produced and repeated. The ring counter can be used for counting the number of pulses. The number of counted pulses is read by noting which flip-flop is in state 1. There is no decoding circuitry required for this type of a counter. Since there is one pulse at the output for each of the n clock pulses, the circuit is also referred to as divide by n counter or a n is to 1 scalar. Ring counters can be instructed for any desired mod number. That is, mod n ring counter requires n flip-flops. Let us move to the next counter, which is the Johnson's counter. A Johnson's counter, the complement of the output of the last stage is connected back to the D input of the first flip-flop. This feedback arrangement produces a characteristic sequence of states. You can see the sequence of states is tabulated in the table below. At the 0th clock pulse, all the outputs are 0, 0, 0, 0. When I give the clock pulse 1, Q0 becomes equal to 1. All other outputs are what? 0. When I give the next clock pulse, I get Q0 and Q1 both as 1, and Q2 and Q3 are equal to 0. When I give the next clock pulse, you get Q0 is equal to 1, Q1 is equal to 1, Q2 is equal to 1 and Q3 is 0. When I give the next clock pulse, I have Q0 is equal to 1, Q1 is equal to 1, Q2 is equal to 1 and Q3 is equal to 1. What happens at the next clock pulse? Q3 Q0 becomes 0, but Q1, Q2 and Q3 are still 1, 1, 1. At the next clock pulse, Q0 and Q1 become 0, 0, Q2 and Q3 are still 1, 1. At the next clock pulse, Q0, Q1, Q2 become 0, 0, 0, Q3 is 1. At the next clock pulse, all of them become equal to 0, 0, 0. The operation of the 4-bit Johnson's counter is tabulated in the table shown below. You can have a 5-bit Johnson's counter also, as shown. You can see that the complement of the output is connected back to the D input of the first flip-flop. The timing diagram is as shown. It is similar to the timing diagram of the 4-bit Johnson's counter, which we have seen. Only the difference over here is that you will have the output of Q0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, since it is a 5-bit Johnson's counter. I have tabulated the sequence of the states of a 5-bit Johnson's counter in the tabular form over here. You can see that in case of a 4-bit Johnson's sequence counter, you have 8 states or bit patterns, and in the 5-bit sequence has total 10 states. In general, a Johnson's counter will produce a modulus of 2n, where n is the number of stages in the counter. You can see from the clock pulses, you have 8 stages, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. That is why it is said that a Johnson's counter will produce a modulus of 2n states, where n is the number of stages in the counter. What are the number of stages in the counter? You have 1, 2, 3 and 4. Suppose you have a 6 stages in the counter, you will have 6 into 2, that you will have 12 stages in case of the modulus. You will have 6 into 2, that is 12 stages or 12 sequences in the case of a 6-bit Johnson's counter. That's all for the Johnson's counter and the ring counter. We will see what are the applications of these counters. Ring counters are used to count the data in a continuous loop. They are also used to detect the various numbers, values or various patterns within a set of information by connecting AND or OR logics to the ring counter circuit. Johnson's counter can be used in a stepper motor controller. Johnson's counters are used to divide the frequency of the clock signal by varying their feedback. You should remember one thing, that in case of a ring counter, the output is connected back to the first stage of the input, whereas in case of the Johnson's counter, the complement of the output is connected back to the first stage of the input. Ring counters give you n states or n sequences, whereas the modulus of the Johnson's counter is 2n. That's all for the case of the ring counter and the Johnson's counter. Thank you.